This slide presentation concerns the Pacific sardine. In culinary and fishery contexts, sardine are arguably one of the most important and popular fish in the world. Out of the 7.5 billion people on the planet Earth, it is just about everyone who has either eaten or heard of sardine. From the finest restaurants in Paris, Hong Kong, and Milan, to the mountain climbing base camps of Mount Everest, we find sardine preparations in one form or the other. So let us take a look at the Pacific sardine. The Pacific sardine live in open waters around the world. They can be found in such diverse locations as the coast off of Africa in the Atlantic Ocean, and from the Pacific, from the coast of Alaska, all the way down to the Gulf of California. Pacific sardine are silvery in color, shade slightly in gray on its back, and they are no more than 6 to 10 inches in length. This video of the Pacific sardine was shot at the Scripps Aquarium in San Diego, California. Sardine tend to swim with the mouth opening and closing. That is the way they breathe. And that is the way they feed on the plankton in the ocean. Sardines are at the bottom of the aquatic food chain, and since they live in open waters and they feed solely on plankton, they are less contaminated by the heavy metals such as mercury and other contaminants found in fish. Sea mammals and most of forage fish depend on sardines as food. At the very top of that food chain, sardines' worst enemy is human commercial fishermen. Since sardines swim and live in huge schools, catching them is a very easy task. Other than tasting delicious, sardine fish are very nutritious. Sardines are full of vitamins. They are an excellent source of the heart-protecting fish oil. The global sardine market reached a volume of 3.5 million tons in 2017. Let's take a closer look at the recent biomass of our Pacific sardine. United States government statistics show there is a critical 98% decline of the Pacific Coast sardine population during the years from 2006 to 2017. If nothing is done to reverse this ominous trend, Pacific sardine extinction is a real possibility. There are many reasons for the Pacific sardine population decline calamity. Greedy overfishing is one, then human environmental pollution, changing climate, shifting destruction of habitat, and many other factors have contributed to our Pacific sardine critical biomass decline. This negative Pacific sardine population trend, it has immense adverse implications for our other Pacific marine inhabitants who depend on sardine as food. Fortunately, efforts are being made globally to restrict the sardine catch at a steady rate. In 2015, a law was passed in the United States that put a moratorium on commercial sardine fishing in all the United States marine waters. This law remains on the books. The good news is for the Pacific sardine, but more needs to be done. We need to join forces globally with other countries to protect our environment, to stop overfishing, and to conserve all of our natural resources. The top five major references for this product are as shown. Tell me when you're ready. George Meyer, writer and producer of the television show The Simpsons, is also a passionate supporter and speaker for the Environmental Protection Organization. Conservation International is his organization. And George is quoted as saying, "If there is a reason for hope, it lies in man's occasional binges of cooperation. To save our planet, we need that kind of heroic effort in which all types of people join force for the common good." I am Edward Menardis, longtime friend of Paul, and on behalf of myself, we say thank you.